Hi and welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to build a virtual machine in Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager. On the screen, you can see there are three virtual machines. These are the three virtual machines which I have already created. Now I am going to create a new virtual machine, that is a fourth machine. Let us see how do I do that. For that, first you need to download this Oracle VirtualBox from Google. Open your Chrome browser or any browser which you have and then type Oracle VM VirtualBox. Click here. However, I'll share the link in the description for download. You can directly download from there. You can download the latest version. Once you click on this download option, you will have the Windows platform or X host or Linux or Solaris. You can just click on Windows host and it is getting downloaded here. You can see it is 103 MB size. So it has been downloaded. You can just click on it and install the application. And installation is very simple. So I am skipping the installation procedure. You just need to click next, next, next and so on. Since I have already installed the Oracle VM VirtualBox, I am skipping the installation. Okay. If you face any issues with the installation, please do comment below. Let me open the VirtualBox application. So this is VirtualBox application from Oracle. Just go to here and click new. Here, give the machine name. Let me give a 104 and select the type of OS. I'm going with Microsoft Windows. And select the version. You need 34-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit, Windows 7, 8, 8.1 and so on. So here I am going with Windows 7, 64-bit and click next. And here you are going to allot the RAM size. You can drag this horizontal roller here and there and you can adjust the RAM or you can directly mention the RAM size 1024. Which is 1 GB. The recommended size here you can see is 2048 MB, okay, but I am going with 1 GB only. Click next and you can choose the virtual hard disk option. Here I am going with create a virtual hard disk. Now go and create and select the hard disk file type. You need the virtual disk image or virtual hard disk or virtual machine disk. I am going with the first option, virtual box disk image. Click next. And how you want the storage on physical hard disk? I want it to be dynamically allocated instead of fixed size. Click next and give the hard disk size. Here you can place this machine in one of the local drives if you want. By default it will go to the C folder, but I'd want it to other folder. So I just click on this folder button and select the drive here. I am going with this drive and machine name is A104. Click save and allocate memory is 32 GB. Let me give a 20 GB and create. So machine has been created, but you cannot start this machine because you have not selected the disk image file for Windows. If you still want to start, you will face error. Let me show you that. Let me start this machine. It will ask you to select the startup disk. So first you need to download the Windows file that you need to download from the internet. I will show you that also. Open your browser. You can download Windows Server 2012 or 2016. Here I am going with Windows Server 2012 R2. However, I will share this link in the description. You can download it from there. So this is the Microsoft website. You can see here, this is our trial versions and these are valid for 180 days. So I am going with Windows Server 2012 R2. select ISO file and click continue. Give the details here. You can give anything here. And continue. Once you click continue, you can select the platform whether your Windows is in 32 bit or 64 bit. 64, and select the language and click download. The file is getting downloaded here. You can see here it is around 4.2 GB. So it is downloaded. So this is the image file. You need to browse this image file. Go back to your VirtualBox, select this machine, click on settings and then go to storage, and here you can see the disk as empty, right? So select this disk, choose virtual optical disk file. I'll show you once again. Go to storage, select this disk. Go to here, this disk symbol, and choose virtual optical disk file and browse the Windows Server 2012 disk. So this is the Windows Server 2012 disk file and OK. So, and in settings, you can also manage the RAM from here after you created also. And in the network, you can select host only adapter. Okay. And you can also use the shared folders option. You can share the local drive to the virtual machine. Go to here share folder and click on this plus symbol. Give the path. Browse the path. Like this. And auto mount. Okay. Now I'm going to start the virtual machine since I have already attached the disk image. So once I start the virtual machine, the setup begins. You can see here on the screen, the setup has begun. Select the language, time and currency format and click next. So I'm going with English United States. And install now. Setup is starting. Here, select the operating system you want to install. Go with the data center evaluation server with GUI option, the fourth one, okay? And click next. Accept the license terms. Click next. Upgrade install or custom install. So I'm going with custom installation. Click next. So this is the disk, hard disk which we have allotted, 20 GB. Click next. So installing Windows on the virtual machine. So this process might take some time depending upon your local PC hardware, because this virtual machine is using the same hardware of your local machine. And remember, this virtual machine is going to use the resources of your local machine only when it is running. So this RAM, which is 1 GB which we have allotted to this virtual machine, is utilized only when this machine is in running state. Otherwise, it is not going to consume the local resources if it is in power off mode. So I'm just skipping the installation time. So installation is almost completed. The last step, finishing the setup. So Windows need to restart the machine to continue. Let me restart now. It is getting restarted. So it is starting. Getting devices ready. So it is again restarting. Here do not press any key. It automatically gets up. Windows is starting. And related to this Oracle VM VirtualBox and hardware requirements and entire documentation, if you want to learn more about this, I am sharing a link in the description. You can click on that link and you can learn more about this Oracle VM VirtualBox and the virtualization. Okay, so give the username is administrator and give the password. Give some password. I have given my password and click finish. And machine has been set up. Just press Ctrl Alt Delete to sign in. Go here, input, keyboard, insert, Ctrl Alt Delete. Enter your password. Please wait. Since this is the first time, it might take some time. Preparing Windows. The screen might go blank for some time during the setup. Please wait for some time and have patience during the installation. So our machine is ready. Here the machine is not visible for full view. For that you need to install the Guestbox edition. I'll show you that. Go here, devices, insert guest edition CD image. Just click on this. Nothing happens. Just click on it. Now go to file manager in the virtual machine. Go here, file explorer. When you go here, you will have this CD drive VirtualBox guest editions. Just click on this and install the files. So you can also adjust the text size. I'll show you later. Click this and install. If you install this, you can able to view your virtual machine full screen like your local PC. Click next. Next, nothing you need to do, just click next and install. Would you like to install this device software? Yes. Install. After installing, you need to just restart this virtual machine. This also might take some time, so I'm just skipping this time. Install successfully. Just reboot now. That is, you can restart it. Otherwise, you can just go here. I want to manually reboot later. I'll also show you how to increase the text size. Then we'll restart the machine so that text size can be increased. I mean, you can see a text large. So go here, control panel and appearance, make text and other items larger or smaller. Let me choose one scaling level for all my displays. Tick this, you will get medium 125% and apply. Sign out now. So it is restarting. Sign in. Give the password. So you can see here it has become full screen once I enter my password. So now this view gives same as your local PC view, right? So this is my virtual machine. You can just minimize and you can check. This is my virtual machine. You can maximize it. So you will get this full screen view and only when you install this guest editions. Okay. and you can see the text is also increased. The size of the text also increased. So it just looks like my local PC. If you have any shared folder, you can view here. You can go here, computer, map network drive, and you can map the shared folders here. Okay. So this is how we create a virtual machine using Oracle VM VirtualBox. Okay. And you can also see the Windows license valid for 180 days, which is 6 months. Since this is evaluation edition, it is valid only for 6 months. Okay. So in case of any queries, please do comment below. And if you like the video, please hit the like button, share, and do subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.